Okay, so basically what I'm doing, this is like how everything's supposed to go in the extension, in this extension. This post is basically just to drop a line to where I have it marked at the perimeter fence over there. So when I put my mesquite post here, I can switch that fence by the fruit trees up here to the front. This little post basically is the edge of where basically the fruit trees is at, like how it's all lined up. This is where this post is at. So when this is lined up, there should be a post right here of a mesquite, and then there should be a post right next to this, and that should hold up the gate of the way that's in the back. You can barely see this post, but you can see it a little bit, that white dragging right here. This post to this post is 12 feet, and then this post to the next one is 12 feet. Same thing in the back, 12 feet, 12 feet, 12 feet. All these here are separated by 12 feet. What I'm gonna do next, in the next couple of weeks, is I'm gonna bring 20-foot rebar and do the same thing I did with the fruit trees in the back. And, you know, I'm gonna try and weld it on there and then curve it and then weld it on and then start putting some mesh, some metal mesh, and plant grapes. There'll be one grape in between every post, so they would still be separated every 12 feet. And this little section is the start of that. So there'll be four grapes in this section, and they would basically crawl up and do like a shaping. And in the future, I might be able to do something where I might have some raised beds underneath all this. We're not sure yet. But let's move on to these posts. Now this post from that post is 8 feet. And I did that for basically like walking space. There's 8 feet of walking space because the grapes are probably gonna take about 2 feet for like watering and then 2 feet for watering here. So I lose about maybe 2 feet to 3 feet in the walking space. So I'll have like 6 feet by maybe 5 feet of walking space throughout here. The same thing, there's a post here, 12 feet this way is another, 12 feet over there is another. You can barely see that post, but it's right here. And I'm not sure what's gonna go here. I was thinking probably like berries, but if there's no berries, if I can't do any berries, then I'll do another set of grapes. But if I do berries, I think I could do 3 or 2 berries per little section here. Now, in the front of these posts, from where that line's at, it's another 5 feet for walking space. I know I could probably like do it where I have 2 feet of walking space and then a post, and 2 feet of walking space, and then a post, and then I'll still have about 4 feet of walking space in the back there. But I just don't want these to be overcrowded. I want them to have a little bit of room, such as I designed the trees back there, where like, okay, they meet the requirements, but they still have enough room. That's kind of what this is. And I also don't want to have a post and some berries or grapes right next to the main fence, because then, you know, the wildlife will get at it. They will get at it. They'll tear the fence out to get at it. In this case, it's kind of a little far off, where if there's fruit or anything, they can't reach it to the point where, like, if they're gonna get in, they're gonna get in, but it's not right there where they can just push themselves in and then yank at the plant. So that's what's going on here with this little grid. You know, we're gonna have hoops, and this is all been straight. Now, if what I get gets higher, then I will basically get, you know, some 8 foot, you know, cut some rebar, you know, maybe at 8 feet, and then, you know, weld it on here. That way it could be taller, and then we could drop another line of that mesh on top. But that mesh is 5 feet, so it should get pretty much to this height. That would be pretty good. The rebar, you're only gonna get 2 feet on the post, and then 2 feet on the post, and then the curvature is gonna be 18 feet. And I think the curvature of that is 6 feet. So basically I'm looking at 11 foot, you know, hoop structure when it comes to the brakes. But that's what's going on here with these posts. I am going to continue basically as much as I can that way. I think I have the ability to do like maybe like another section, do another 24 feet that way. But for right now, that's what we're working on here. So that's pretty much it. We extended the garden, and this right here is just temporary, this little fence here, because the extension is that portion over there. Now, this is here because if I would have just left it open, it just, the whole garden would have been open and anything could get in and do what it wants. So this is just to hold animals back. Now it's temporary because that gate should be up here in the front. And we're gonna move that as we build up like the chicken coop and all that stuff. Like that's how that's when that's gonna be moved up here. So this is temporary right now. But let me show you the little fence. So this is the fence, you know, mesquite post. And then this is the same fence that was over there on those posts. So basically I just unhooked it all and then brought it here and tied it all up to these new posts. The new extension is 21 feet. So it's 21 feet this way and then it's like 70 feet all the way across. And even though it's the same size fence of over there, I still stretched it a little bit just so it could be a little tighter. And it's actually pretty nice. It's holding on pretty nice. So here we are towards the back. Now on this side, I basically tied like three different fences. There was a portion of when I did the whole fence, I got that, and there was like a little section that was about like maybe a foot, and then like a foot that was left that I chopped off at the edge of this main post. And basically I tied those three together, and then in the back here I basically grabbed some of that random fence that I had. It's a little shorter, and I basically just put it here and I stretched it to the next post. In the future, I am gonna buy some more fencing and then like tie it all the way good. And then same thing here. Here's a T-post. I added a T-post in the back here because that's where the line is. And then I just basically tied a little portion of this back fence over here. I cut it and then I put it here. And then I basically just pulled, you know, this chain link fence that I had as the gate over there, and then I basically just hooked it on here, tied it, and then tied it to the T-post. This is supposed to be a gate, and the thing about that is I'm gonna put a 12-foot gate here. So, you know, this chain link fence here is also temporary because I'm gonna drill some hooks into the post there and then put the gate, and then the gate will hook on to this T-post technically. So for right now, we don't really use this gate anymore since we basically cleared out that area and added that gate over there a long time ago. So instead of just having it loose, I basically just tied it to the T-post. And that's basically it on this portion. I do got some stuff like that pile of rocks and some compost, stuff I gotta move out of here. But, you know, next thing is just basically planting the grapes and then setting up their type of wire and then, you know, hoops and everything for them and all that stuff. And that's what's gonna go here, and plumbing. So that's coming up pretty soon here. But that's pretty much it on this video. You know, thank you for joining us, and please comment, like, subscribe, ask questions, and we'll get back to you. Thank you.